Thanks for joining us today. Welcome to the Center for State's video series on the essential functions for monitoring, evaluating, and applying findings. This series is produced by the Capacity Building Center for States and funded by the Children's Bureau. The Monitoring, Evaluating, and Applying Findings brief is intended to help child welfare agency leaders, managers, and stakeholders take a structured approach to plan for and execute strategies to monitor and evaluate implementation efforts and interventions, strategies to collect and analyze data for a variety of evaluation types, and then using data to make decisions and plan for sustainability of programs where feasible. It does this by providing step-by-step guidance to strategize and develop a plan for evaluation, collect and analyze data and consider fidelity and costs, and then use the results to make decisions about ongoing efforts and sustainability. The Monitoring, Evaluating, and Applying Findings brief is broken down into 4 parts and 11 essential functions or tasks. It is important to remember that while the steps are presented in a linear way, in practice, often these steps will overlap and be revisited as teams continue to monitor, evaluate, and apply their findings over time. Part 1 is setting the stage and includes considering the circumstances and needs of the agency, developing a logic model, identifying questions to explore, and the topic of this module, which is identifying the data measures, sources, and collection methods that will answer them, and then developing an evaluation plan. Part 2 is collect and analyze data, and it includes strategies to put the evaluation plan into place by collecting and analyzing the data outlined, and then 2 special featured topics that are a version of data collection and analysis. They are examining fidelity and analyzing costs. Part 3 outlines how to use the data collected to make decisions and adjustments, with 2 functions on sharing findings and recommendations, and then making decisions to further spread, adjust, or discontinue. And Part 4 is on sustainability planning and how teams should refine and implement a plan to sustain interventions when this is the decision of the team and stakeholder groups. Let's get started. Why do teams need to identify measures, data sources, and potential data collection methods? To help them move from the logic model process to an actual plan for evaluation. To identify what data the team might have access to that could answer the questions of interest, and what gaps there are or additional data they might need to answer the questions. And to identify the methods and tools they might have access to or need to develop to collect the data needed. How do teams identify measures, data sources, and potential data collection methods? Teams should identify the data they need to answer the selected questions and understand their intervention's functioning, progress towards goals, and effects on desired changes. A measurement framework is a useful tool to help teams transition from the logic model to an evaluation plan. Teams should review their identified questions and consider the following elements when creating the framework. Teams should detail the measures, including both qualitative and quantitative information and data that can be used to assess whether progress was made toward the desired change. These may include process, fidelity, and outcome measures, and they should reflect how the intervention is functioning. In data collection sources, teams should outline where the relevant data comes from, for example, administrative databases, program records and logs, case files, staff, or service participants. Teams should also outline their data collection methods, their strategies for collecting the data from the sources, which may include examining administrative data, reviewing program or case records, conducting surveys, interviews, or focus groups with program staff or service participants, observing staff service delivery and completing checklists, or administering assessment instruments. And teams should also outline the data collection frequency, or how often the data will be collected. In order for teams to answer their evaluation questions and have a better understanding of the data they should examine multiple sources when possible. Using both quantitative data or numerical data that measure and quantify what, who, and when, and qualitative data, which is narrative data that explores and provides context about how and why. This strengthens the team's answers to their questions of interest. Both quantitative and qualitative data can be collected through various methods, such as a review of records or administrative data, observation, surveys, interviews, focus groups, tests, or assessment tools. While thinking about data collection, teams should also consider the steps they need to take to make any changes to documentation and reporting. The availability of developed tools or instruments to collect the data that are validated or have been used by others with similar interventions. Or potential data sharing with other agencies or partners who serve the target population and the agreements that would be needed to put in place. Teams will want to factor in the time it takes to incorporate these considerations, and it helps to begin these steps early in the implementation process. As teams are developing their measurement framework, they should also consider what data may be valuable for ongoing monitoring of programs and interventions. For example, in a home visiting program, routine monitoring might include tracking the number of families enrolled, percentage of families eligible enrolled, number and duration of home visits. This data would be available through a variety of sources, such as program records, databases, or case reviews, and might need to be reported in alignment with agency or funding requirements. Exploring more complex questions about why or why not an intervention is effective, how it is effective, and what outcomes resulted generally fall to more rigorous evaluation efforts and typically involve additional data sources and study designs. Teams should review key questions and considerations when identifying measures, data sources, and potential data collection methods. What data are needed to answer the questions of interest? How will inputs, outputs, and outcomes be measured? What are key data sources related to these measures? Are these sources credible? How can data be collected from the source, and is data collection feasible? And are data collection methods culturally appropriate? What existing instruments are available, and what new ones will have to be developed? How can data sharing help collection? What agreements will be needed? And how can security and confidentiality be preserved? Discussing these questions as a team will strengthen the team's ability to identify the measures, sources, and collection methods that will help to answer the questions of interest. Let's take a look at an example of part of a measurement framework for an in-home visitation program. The framework outlines the questions of interest, the output or outcome associated with the question, the measures that the team will need to track to answer the questions, the data sources and methods that will provide the data, and how often the data should be collected. For the question, was the home visiting component delivered as intended? The output or outcome would be home visits. The measures might include the number of visits, duration of visits, time spent on topics, and family engagement behaviors. The data collection method or sources might include case file reviews, home visitor logs, observation, or surveys of home visitors and parents. And the frequency of data collection might be monthly or every 3 months among the sample. Let's look at another sample question. Are families receiving home visits more likely to experience improvements in positive parent-child interactions? The output or outcome might include positive parent-child interactions. The measures might include the use of identified positive parenting and discipline techniques. The data collection method or source might be observation and/or interviews with home visitors and parents. And the frequency of data collection might be upon entering the program and every 3 months after. A team's work on the measurement framework will help to make further decisions about the work needed to create and execute the evaluation plan. Let's take a moment to check in on what you've learned about identifying measures, data sources, and potential data collection methods. Why do teams identify measures, data sources, and potential collection methods? To move from the logic model to an evaluation plan, identify any data gaps there are and the tools they might need to collect new data. How do teams identify measures, data sources, and potential collection methods? By developing a preliminary measurement framework, identifying the data sources and collection methods, and considering how the data will inform evaluation of the effort and reporting. What can help teams identify measures, data sources, and potential collection methods? By considering as a team the data needed to answer the questions, the reliability and feasibility of collecting the data needed, and what tools or data partnerships can help. Now take this a step further by reviewing the reflection questions for identify measures, data sources, and potential data collection methods in your monitoring, evaluating, and applying findings workbook to connect what you've learned to your own experience. Up next is develop an evaluation plan, the sixth module in this series and the fifth essential element in setting the stage for monitoring and evaluation.
This video was created by the Capacity Building Center for States, funded by the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, Administration for Children and Families, Children's Bureau, under contract HHS P2332014-00033C. The content of this video does not necessarily reflect the official views of the Children's Bureau.